No, really. Are you guys ready for 2014 Mock Rock? Y'all ready for this? What's up? All right. We have about 5 acts performing tonight, so it's gonna be a good time. We're gonna see some funny stuff. I mean, we got some big surprises for you guys, if that makes sense. You see. So, you know what? We're gonna go ahead and introduce you guys to the honorary judges for tonight. There you go. Thanks, Jason. So our first judge for tonight, you guys might know her for her psychological weird brain powers. Really good stuff up there. She has a huge personality, one of the most loved, I guess, faculty members on campus, I would say. Miss Jamie Sparks over here. All right, next up, where are my basketball players at? No basketball players here tonight? Okay, no. So next up, we got somebody who you're gonna find them in the gym shooting basketball, in the weight room working out, or probably in McDonald's getting fat, but you know. Anyways, we're gonna bring out Coach Tony Romero right now. He's not fat, he's fit. You know, fit mind, body, heart, soul, mind, you know, fit for it, there we go. All right, next up, this is who I personally like to call the candy lady on campus, if you know what I'm saying. Like, every time I go into my classrooms, I'm always going to reach into the candy basket. Let's give it up for Missy Mays here. Now, any baseball players up in here? Okay, we got one or two. Never mind. All right, so any of you guys Mets fans? New York? Yeah? Ooh, okay. Well, we got Micah Mets coming. All right. As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I take a look at my life and realize it's nothing left. Cause I've been blasting and laughing. Yeah. That even my mama thinks that my mind is gone. All right, without further ado, we're gonna go ahead and get the show started. Y'all ready for that? So, our first act of the night, any of you Catholics, denomination of Catholic in here? Oh, we got one or two, okay, never. All right, you guys like nuns? You like nuns? I like nuns. So the first act of the night are gonna be the nuns, y'all, enjoy.
Follow him wherever he may go.
up again for the nuns, y'all. What's up? Moment of seriousness right now. Anybody want to hear a joke?
No. Joke?
Yes. We got some, yes. Got some notes? Yes. I don't think the nuns will be too fond of this, but I'm going to go ahead and say this anyways. No. So God created the earth, right?
Yeah.
And then he rested. God created man.
And then he rested.
Then he rested.
Sorry.
Huh? Yeah. God created women. Since then, neither God or men have rested. No, but in all seriousness, what's going on over there?
Hi. We in the English department are concerned about the tone of culture on this campus. So I'm here to make sure that things don't get too, yeah. Well, I don't know that that joke helped.
Well, is there anything you'd like to add?
In fact, I have been experimenting with a new approach to the oral performance of poetry that I think that will be insightful and innovative and I think entertaining. Right. I call it...
Let's hear it.
Dynamic persona vocalization. Basically, it's reading things with voices. Now, that last, I think, with the nuns and all, like, sort of set a high tone, but nothing sets a higher tone than Shakespeare. So I'm going to give you Hamlet's soliloquy. Now, Hamlet is a youth, and he vacillates between extreme self-confidence and a kind of awkward hesitation. So I think nothing voices that much much better than, Eric Cartman. So,
to be or not to be? That is the question. Whether 'tis nobler in a man to suffer slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against a sea of troubles and by opposing in them, to die to sleep no more, and by sleep to say we end the heartache and the thousand natural shocks to which the flesh is heir. I lost my place. 'Tis consummation devoutly to be wished, to die, to sleep, perchance to dream. For in that sleep what dreams may come when we have shuffled off this mortal coil must give us pearls. There's the respect that makes calamity of so long life.
I think I've raised the tone.
Wow. Glad I'm not an English major, huh? All right, up next we have for you guys. All right, we're gonna call them the Retrophiliacs. You guys give a round of applause for them?
Thank you. As a child of the 80s, I have pretty thoroughly, but nonetheless. Nonetheless. We'll let it go at that.
All right. Well, I would ask the judges what they think about that, but then they'll be judging them. Somebody laugh. Okay. Just laugh. Another joke, or should we? You guys decide.
Another joke.
Another joke? Joke. Okay. Caleb Chase says, joking up. Where's Micah Church? Ah, there goes Micah Church. All right, all right. Hey, Micah. I've heard you're a pretty smart guy on campus. I heard you know a little something. Answer this question for me. How many seconds are in a year? No idea. Anybody? Anybody? No? It's really simple. It's about 12 seconds in here. You got January 2nd, February 2nd, March 2nd. You get the idea. All right. I mean, am I the, you know what? Next up. You guys want to hear another joke? Oh, Aaron, next up, for real. So this time we have what we like to call the love experts. Give a round of applause, you guys.
Holding back from such a man. Is it the clumpy way he walks?
Or the grumpy way he talks?
Or the pear-shaped, square-shaped weirdness of his feet?
And though we know he washes well, he always ends up sort of smelly.
But you'll never meet a fellow who's as
sensitive and sweet. So he's a bit of a fixer-upper, so he's got a few flaws.
Like his peculiar reindeer.
This thing with the reindeer
that's a little outside of nature's laws.
So he's a bit of a fixer-upper, but this we're certain of. You can fix this fixer-upper up with a little bit of love.
Can we please just stop talking about this? We've got a real, actual problem here.
I'll say.
So tell me, dear, is it the way that he runs scared,
or that he's socially impaired?
So she's a bit of a fixer-upper.
That's a minor thing.
Her quote engagement is a flex arrangement.
And by the way, I don't need no ring.
So she's a bit of a fixer-upper. Her brain's a bit of a twix. Get the Beyoncé out of the way, and the holy will be fixed.
We're not saying you can change him, cause people don't really change. We're only saying that love's a force that's powerful and strange. People make bad choices if they're mad or scared or stressed. Throw a little light their way.
You'll bring out their best. True love brings out the best. Everyone's a bit of a fixer-upper. That's what it's all about.
Father,
sister,
brother.
We need each other to raise us up and round us out. Everyone's a bit of a fixer-upper. But when push comes to shove,
that can fix a fixer-upper is
true, 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 true.
Do you, Anna, take Christoph to be your trollfully wedded?
What?
You're getting married.
Oh yeah. Socially impaired, eh, Jason? I have a little joke for you guys. Nah, I'm just playing. So, but in all reality though, we have a public service announcement from the English department. Without further ado, I'm gonna go ahead and turn it over to Mr. Grubbs here.
We in the English department approve of the Scandinavian influence in that last piece. We like Scandinavian things, we like Viking stuff. I like Beowulf. So I would like to give you at least a snippet of one of my new favorites of Scandinavian verse. This one is strong enough that I don't think it actually has to be read in a voice. Dog goes woof. Cat goes meow, bird goes tweet, and mouse goes squeak. Cow goes moo, and frog goes croak, and elephant goes toot. Duck say quack, and fish go blub, and seal goes ow, ow, ow. But there's one sound that no one knows. What does the puck say? Ring, ding, 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 ring, ding, 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 ring, ding, 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 ring, ring, ding, 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 ding. What does the fox say? There's more in that vein. Big blue eyes, pointy nose, chasing mice, digging holes, tiny paws up the hill. Suddenly you're standing still. Your fur is red, so beautiful. Like an angel in disguise. But if you met a friendly horse, would you communicate in ma-o-o-o-o-orse? 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 Will you, how will you speak to that ho-o-o-o-orse? Ho-o-o-o-orse? And so forth. Yeah, I like this one.
Yeah. Yeah. Well,
Scandinavia. Yeah.
And my wire is out.
So, we got any Beyonce fans out there? Oh, come on, Beyonce, that's the only woo you get? All right, up next we got for you all what we like to call the 3 G's.
Another brother noticed me. I'm up on him, look on me, don't pay him any attention.
Well, you know. I got a story to tell y'all. Or you all. Y'all, I'm from Texas. Or someone. You know how it works.
Yeah.
Y'all is correct. Oh, he's an English major too. Y'all. Yeah.
Y'all.
I'll take that. All right, so there was this ship, right? Kind of like the Titanic, just not so Titanic-y, not big, not, you know, cruise liner. More like a yacht, let's say a yacht, yeah. There was a ship, right? Cruising down the ocean in a shipwreck, right? Not an iceberg or nothing like that. Maybe like a rock or a boulder or something. Something, you know, not so Titanic-y, of course. But anyways, so there's a shipwreck, right? Captain comes out, he's like, does anybody know how to pray? You guys know how to pray? No? Yeah? Okay, a little bit of prayer going on out there. Okay, Jesus, all right. Well, okay. This guy comes up, he's like, I know how to pray. I know how to pray. Captain says, all right, you go pray while we put on our life jackets because we're one short. No. All right, it wasn't that funny, but still, you get the concept. And I still filled the time, and it still got the job done. Anyways, now, next up, we have Captain Crunch and the Serial Killers. Let's give a round of applause for these guys.
We gonna get it started, man. I'm feeling so fresh tonight. Yes, yes. You know, I'm seeing all the beautiful people. Everybody rocking their favorite brands. Whatever your favorite brand is, it's whatever you want to do, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, I didn't always have it like that. We didn't always have it, you know what I'm saying? So this is what we had to do to look fly, you know what I'm saying? This is how I used to get it in. And, yo, I used to go to the mall with $40 a hand.
Nothing better. Oh, oh, oh. The girls ask the guys, it's
knocking the wolf on your neck. What you know what I'm about wearing a fur box? What? And I'm digging, I'm searching right through that luggage. One man's trash, that's another man's come up. What? Like your granddad, we're donating that plaid button up shirt. Cause right now I'm up in her skirt. I'm at the Goodwill, you can find me in the I'm not stuck on searching in the section. Your grandma, your auntie, your mama, your mammy. I'll take those flannel zebra jammies secondhand and rock that. Whoa. The built-in onesie with the socks on them. Whoa. I hit the party and they stop in that. Whoa. They be like, oh, that Gucci, that's hella tight. I'm like, yo, that's $50 for a t-shirt. Limited edition, let's do some simple edition. $50 for a t-shirt, that's just some ignorant. I call that getting swindled and pimped. I call that getting tricked by a business. That's your hella dough. And having the same one as six other people in this club is a hella don't beat gang. Come take a look through my telescope, trying to get girls from my friend and you hella.
Show is not over. Matter of fact, so much light up here. There we go. Make sure you keep it a little lit. You know. Well, I think at this time, I think our judges are gonna handle some things, get some judging going on, maybe get some, we may end up having to take the crowd's votes, so just in case, maybe thinking about that. Let's do this real quick. Let's go over who actually performed. We got the Nuns. All right, we got the Retrophiliacs. The Love Experts. We got the 3 G's, I'm not Beyonce, you know, there we go. And then we got Captain Crunch and the Serial Killer. So you guys be thinking about that just in case. Right about now, I think, let me just check my schedule here. I wrote all this down myself. It's not really a schedule. It's like stuff. Yeah, so.
That's worse than that.
So, right about now, I think the English department, or Now, when I say English department, I don't want to misrepresent the English department. So this might be just Mr. Grubbs, or it might represent the English department. Dr. Grubbs. There we go. Dr. Grubbs. The doctor is in the house. All right. But really, though,
Just don't die. I can't do anything about that.
He doesn't practice medicine. Anyways, yeah, so I think Dr. Grubbs here has a little something he would like to relay upon you all.
Is that fine? Is that cool?
Yeah. Wait, before you go, I have to ask one question.
Yeah.
Before you read the Shakespeare, yeah, you said a V word, but you wanted to facilitate or vascularize. I'm not English. I don't really know.
I don't know. Vocalization. That's the word.
Yeah. Okay. All right, sweet. Well, I'm gonna vocally give the stage over to Dr. Grubbs. Dr. Grubbs, y'all.
That was neat. I like that last act. I think their act was about throwing things. All right. All right. We've had a lot of levity tonight. However, there are serious things in life that I think need to be considered. And no one better speaks for the serious side of life than Edgar Allan Poe. And no voice better speaks for the serious side of life than Hanna-Barbera's own droopy dog. So,
The Weaving by Edgar Allan Poe. Once upon a midnight dreary, when I pondered weak and weary over many a quaint and curious volume of forgotten lore, while I nodded nearly napping, suddenly there came a tapping, as of someone gently rapping at my chamber door. "'Tis some visitor," I muttered, tapping at my chamber door, only this and nothing more. Open here, I flung the shutter, when with many a flirt and flutter, in there stepped a stately raven of the saintly days of yore. Not the oblest, the least obeisance made he, not a minute stopped or stayed he, but with mien of lord or day, perched he above my chamber door, perched upon the burst of palace just above my chamber door, perched and sat and nothing more. Then this ebony bird beguiling my sad fancy into smiling by the grave and stern decorum of the countenance it wore. Though thy crest be shorn and shaven, thou, I said, art sure no craven, grim, ghastly, and ancient raven wandering from the night shore. Tell me what thy lordly name is on the night's Plutonian shore. Quoth the raven, "Nevermore." Do I keep going?
Let's give it up for Grubbs. Woo!
Because I can. Are we at it?
We good?
We got time?
We got jokes. We got stuff.
We got more verses. I could keep going. Or, I did have.
What is that? We good?
We good. What else? No. Nevermore.
That's dangerous. Could have took my dreads off or something.
Yes,
all right. to go sit down first and say that? Yeah. I'm still on. Did you guys hear us talking back there? What? The judges are back. Would you look at there? The judges are back. Let's give a round of applause to the judges, y'all. Do y'all want to hear the results? Yeah. Or should we tell a joke first? Third place, we got the nuns. Second place, we have the Captain Crunch and the Serial Killers. And in first place comes the Retrophiliacs. Wait, I think I did that wrong. That was too fast. The nuns, third place. Second place, Captain Crunch and the Serial Killers. And then first, we got the Retro Philly. Yeah! There we go. Alright. Whoa. All right, you guys, I'm gonna take a bow now. Give the mic over.
Thank you. Okay, I want to thank you guys for coming out, and thank you all for making Mock Rock such a big success. Congratulations to all of you, and especially our winners. I also want to give a big thank you to our lovely judges here. Without them, this would not happen. And also our lovely tech staff in the back, Mr. Justin Warren and Catherine Lott and Jason Palmer. Give it a hand. Thank you. Oh, and also Mr. Grubbs. Thank you. And Morris.
Not my bicep.